one, and when Mark holds that note on that in that break,
yeah,
you really hear that lesson going.
Yeah, you do.
First, I think we gotta fix that.
Right.
Then I think
that's what something I was thinking. Yeah.
But first, you thought we gotta fix
it. Yeah. And it's like it goes by so fast. It's like.
Well, I mean, you'll hear it.
Yeah.
You'll hear it.
Oh yeah.
But it's a lesson working. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah.
We might have to fix it, or we might say fuck it.
Right. Exactly.
This is a real Hammond and a real Leslie.
Yeah, dude.
You know? Pickups. Stick them on that starburst.
Uh-huh. Which one is that? Which wrap is that?
That's one, the guy who built the Eaton house. It's one of his.
Oh, cool.
And, it's their call. I don't know if they're Seymour Duncan's.
I don't know. I want the Fender of the
Are they round balls? The round balls sticking up above the white?
Yeah, the metal poles. But Bernie also told me that his company, which make the pickups on the guitar he built, that they make a pickup called the Vintage Strat.
Oh, cool.
So it might be his too, I don't know. I don't know, but it does sound like a Vintage Strat, I gotta say.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do a whole couple tracks of that shit, and then we'll have to choose from.
Yeah. You know?
There's one part of the, I think it's the choruses of the song, where you kind of hit like a chord. I'll show you. Where I think you might try to. Yeah, I was thinking of more of maybe an arpeggio.
There's going to be another part in
that.
Yeah.
That's what I was hearing, and it was like a little.
That's exactly right. It's gonna be overdub. Mm-hmm. I did that on the scratch track, but then the chords fell out.
Yeah.
I overdub that, I think, with a little different sound.
Uh-huh.
Maybe on the middle pickup or something, you know? Or even the fucking real scratch.
Oh, that's what I said. That same tone you had, I was just saying in that one little part. Because it kind of breaks the verses from the choruses for it, you know? Because you play that little cool rhythm on that, and then going a little bit more of a thing on the other side.
Maybe for now I ought to do a couple of tracks.
want to punch there somewhere?
Yeah, excuse that one.
All right.
Heard him play live, heard his
playfield.
No. He does that shit like
really
no, like nobody. He makes one, Hendrix two, sound like a beginner.
Uh-huh.
down on one track and your arpeggio on the other.
Yeah, I mean, what did you just think of the thing with the two guitars? With that thing?
Going back and forth?
Uh-huh.
Well, it's two tracks, you
right.
know.
Right. I mean, some parts were really cool, and in other parts it kind of sounded like it was a bit much.
Well, you do like four tracks, and then maybe you use
Right, I know what you're saying, but yeah, but as I was saying, the tone and everything is fucking great, though.
You mean on the chorus, it's too much, or
no,
in that break?
In that break.
Oh, the break is, there's going to be a piano going in there, and maybe nothing. I'm just...
Oh, just fucking around, see.
Yeah. You know, can you play me that last chorus?
Yeah.
Right at it on the very ending.
Uh-huh.
With that track I just did, and then the other track that's an arpeggio.
Yeah.
Both of them.
Okay.
Because if that works, I'm going to go back and do all the choruses.
Just the way it's so quiet, the way he had that thing set up, it's just not mic.
Thank you.
Cool.
Yeah, let me try one with a track, and we'll...
Yeah, no problem.
Hey, Dave.
Hey, need me?
Yeah, he wants the amp turned up a little.
Or he might be able to pull it off here.
Or he might be able to have it.
Right here, maybe?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm still hearing maybe it's the scratch guitar or something in here, too.
Shouldn't be.
Yeah, I'm hearing what I'm doing plus another guitar.
Is this backed up or doubled?
Oh, let me check something, make sure. No, we shouldn't be hearing any scratch. Let me just check.
Everybody's dancing. you take. I'll be right here. I see him watching everybody move.
Sounding about 14-year-old right now, which is not a bad thing, you know, in some songs. But I don't know if it'll fit on this record.
A 14-year-old?
Yeah.
How do you mean?
Well, your throat's just like closed up, you know what I mean? It's not really open.
Yeah.
So it's sounding like really thin and teenage-ish,
yeah.
Sort of.
Well, don't want to sound like that.
Yeah. I mean, not to be, you know, an asshole or anything.
Everywhere she goes. inside of me. Have the realization, the true love never dies. I see my final vision when I look in her eyes.
Seven yeah. Vocal patches on Begin Again,
okay.
On the beginning and ending.
Alright.
Bernie's putting on the choruses of this song, he's putting quarter note, either bells or
something on this.
Something on this, yeah.
Okay.
Alright. On Stranger, we can have Bernie do a cowbell, tambourine.
Okay.
This song could use maybe percussion.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. That's why I wanted to have this label for this reel.
Yeah. This song, we could try a bunch of percussion shit. I don't know if we'll use it.
Yeah.
But
cool.
But subtle percussion, not conga army or anything.
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah. Would you play me that second vocal there?
Yeah.
It still ain't the one, but it was a lot easier to sing, for sure.
Yeah.
Martin. Let's give that a listen. Come on in. We might wanna even mess with it a little more. Thank you.
let's give it a listen. You want?
Hey, George. Hey, George.
Martin, you there?
George, yeah. Martin.
Yeah.
If you married him, you'd be Martin Martin.
I'm Martin Martin. I prefer that you're George George. And you'd also, and you'd also be gay.
Yeah. Yeah, if you married boy. Yeah, he's going to be a few minutes. So go ahead. I'm all right for a while. I want to check what he's doing.
Close my eyes and wonder how
What's that third thing on Jimmy?
No, I think it's me going with it. I don't know. We'll figure it. We'll fix it in the next. I was just, Martin, that's beautiful. What I was thinking, I'd like to have you try in the chorus as one of your, like an arpeggio thing that I was going to do on the guitar where it goes to the G, the D, the A minor, the F. I was going to go, da 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 da. It might sound fucking bitching if you do that. Yeah, yeah, it's a great idea. I think as the song went on, you got more into what you were doing.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to play really low in the beginning and then later on. But I want you to take over at one time. That's what's really dominant. And then from then on, people realize, oh, wait a minute, there's a bullet sound there.
Yeah.
And then you start doing some more stuff.
But I mean, through the verses,
yeah,
you can basically do like whole note chords,
right,
like you were doing.
Right, okay.
And then try the arpeggios over the chorus. Except whatever that note was, it's got to be an F major. You know what I'm saying?
Oh.
It doesn't have an E in it. Yeah. And you might even
everywhere that you go.
That's beautiful, Martin. You know what I'm thinking, though? Is on the last verse, yeah, where you're coming in with that,
yeah,
with all the stuff that we got going on in there now, maybe we ought to rethink just what you're playing in there a little. Remember how we changed Please Don't Go, and you were actually like, maybe not even,
just make without the other, just try that, just underneath all the guitar stuff.
Yeah, or you can even,
without doing the, leave that off, just see what it is.
Okay, let's punch in there then.
Okay.